Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with another episode of the Zombie Campaign. Now I have to play as this overpowered ham sandwich. Yes, cubs and kittens, I would like to introduce to you the imp, otherwise known as Pain Incarnate. Yeah, this guy's just an overpowered little piece of trash. So, his main weapon is actually kind of balanced. I will give the imp one thing. His primary weapon is actually kind of okay. Basically, it breaks your camera somehow, but it also has a pretty low accuracy at longer distances. As you can see, the shots kind of spread around a decent bit. And he also has a decently large amount of damage drop-off. Like, his damage is way higher than this at close range. Although, apparently, can still kill weeds, so something to think about. Yeah, damage drop off. That isn't a mechanic I've really explained with a lot of characters. Some characters have a mechanic called damage drop off, where the longer their shot has to travel, then the more damage it loses over that distance. And Imp, I feel, is probably the worst affected by this. His damage drop off is absolutely crazy. And his accuracy drop off, dear God. I mean, I've seen stormtroopers aim better than this guy. Now, as for his abilities, he has the gravity grenade. This is absolute torture for any target who gets pulled into it. Basically, the gravity grenade will pull that target up and sort of keep them locked into position, making them a perfectly still target. His other ability is also Impakata. This is the ability you use when you just can't be asked. You don't have to aim with this ability, it does pretty good damage. Although its range is quite short. The shots don't really spread, just any target within a certain radius of you takes a large amount of damage, about 3 every quarter of a second. Yeah, 3 damage every quarter of a second sounds pretty good to me. Now, of course, yeah, this is another thing I should explain, other than his last ability. He has a jetpack, the butt boosters, as they're called. And oh boy. They make this guy survive so much longer. See, you may notice he only has about 75 hit points. This is the lowest health of any character we've seen so far. In fact, I don't think any character actually has a less health than this guy. But that is off-rated by his butt boosters. This is basically like a double jump. However, you can kind of go in any direction with it, and it kind of keeps you up in the air for a very long time. I feel like this alone is what makes Imp so devastating to deal with. Like, don't get me wrong, he's a fun character, but I really do not play him in multiplayer much because he can be pure pain to fight. But that's the rough thing about Imp. He's fun to play, but very frightening to fight. One of the things that makes this so accentuated and exaggerated is his last ability, the Z-Mech. When you use this Z-Mech, you are a god. This thing is incredibly powerful. In fact, it actually has a battery power. Kind of like the burrow that Chomper uses, this thing has a limited amount of battery power. However, unlike the Chomper's burrow stamina, this battery can go on for quite a long time. It actually drains a little bit faster when you're shooting and moving, so sometimes standing still can preserve it, I believe. Although honestly, it kind of runs for a perfectly fine time, in my opinion. Now, the Z-Mech actually has its own set of abilities, one of them being the Missile Madness. Basically, once you hit the button for it, after a few seconds, this thing will shoot at 20 missiles in a very quick succession. The missiles actually do some pretty decent damage, and you can full-on kill multiple targets with it. Now, his other ability is not quite as powerful, but still pretty good, and that is the Robo Stomp. Basically, it's a lunge-forward sort of stomp attack that can kind of stun enemies, and if they're in any special ability, then it will take them out of it. So, Sunbeam and P-Gatling, like there weren't enough counters to those abilities already. If you die in the Z-Mech, however, then it is completely gone. That's why his last ability is helpful, and that is the Eject, which basically lets you sort of eject out of your mech. There are some very funny things you can do with this, like gravity grenade the mech, thereby pulling nearby targets into its explosion. Yeah. So then, back on to the campaign. Dr. Patient, what is our assignment today? No baloney, no problem. Track down a special secret door-finding device. Only, it's lost, so... Only way to find door is use secret door-finder. The dialogue feels so incomplete. My brain hates voice acting these guys, because it's like I read it and my brain tries to fill in the missing parts of the sentence, and I have to stop myself from actually saying it. I feel like you can hear my fist waving in the microphone right now. That's how bad it is. Finder is missing, though. So... Find finder, find door, get brains! Maybe secret door finder inside plant base. Brains. I love how that's just your response to everything as zombies. Just brains. Brains this, brains that. What if I don't want brains? What if I'm not in the mood? What if they're too high in cholesterol? Get rid of the fence. Do not like fences in this game. Oh, hello there, Janeer. We're about to get very well acquainted with you. Good brains! Can help you get into plant base. Just trying out new teleporter. You help? It kind of safe. Hop in teleporter. We'll be in the plant base in no time. Okay then. Yes, I'm sure that's going to be the case. And no, it just teleported me back here. Yeah. Oh, but at least it did have the decency to teleport me back. Also, why does it just keep spawning brown coats here? This is something I always notice. It just spawns like a ridiculous amount of zombies around here. Like newspaper guys. Oh, hey! Yeah, hey there, Janeer. Maybe teleporter not built right, yeah, I'd say. Hit it hard with hammer, few more times. Oh yeah, because hitting things with a hammer always, always leads to happy results. It ready now. Yep, for sure. Try again. Next up, plant base. Okay. Hey there, do you have a, like, Sudoku puzzle or something? Could I just hang with this guy? I don't wanna go through this portal. Man, it's not gonna work. Oh, hi. Oh, hi, roses, no! No, oh, go, oh, wow, okay. Oh, am I sure I not just... Did I just hop into a multiplayer lobby or something? That was very player-esque. Okay. Why do I have purple sparkles? I swear, this teleporter, I feel like it has... Like, applies some buffs to you sometimes. It's kind of like the designers realized, oh yeah, this thing can teleport you into some crazy deadly situations. Let's give them some buffs so that they can actually survive using it. Hey there, Janeer. Your portal's so bad, I'm pretty sure the developers had to go through extra steps to save me. Okay. Know what you thinking. Oh yeah, I'm thinking that portal is absolutely worthless. That's what I'm thinking. Didn't take you to plant base. Yeah, basically. Okay, but... Just remembered, maybe change air filter. Maybe clogged. This time, teleporting to plant base. Yep, for sure. Yeah, what happened last time? You said, yep, for sure. Oh yeah, I went into the plant base. I went to a Rose's castle. Not where we need to be. Oh god, the Torchwoods. No, 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 no. Instant mechification. Instant mechification. Oh, dear. Oh, Lord. Okay. Okay, Janeer. Alright. I got a word to pick with you. All fixed. Oh, you couldn't have done that before I went there. Okay, cool. Found problem was in test mode. Guaranteed works now. Trust is basis of all brains. You seem to misunderstand how paranoid I am. I do not trust. Why is my camera being... Don't violate my camera like that. My safety is already being violated by this moron. Don't violate my camera. Okay. Okay. We're just in space now. Okay. Yep. I'm honestly, at the rate this portal's going, I'm not even really shocked anymore. Hey, there's an error. Oh, hi! I could just... Janira, I'm going to slap you to the moon. You again? Oh, did you expect me to not come back or something? Maybe we broke teleporter. Janira, I don't think you know how hard it is to keep myself together. No matter. While you zapping around, I build big cannon! New plan. Cannon works good. Climb inside. Can I bring myself to trust again? Can I really bring myself to trust this bumbling plumber's crack idiot? I'm not sure. Well, if this cannon kills me, then, goodbye. Oh, nope, by some miracle it actually works. Way better than the teleporter. Alright. Goody, goody. Hi, everybody. Ah, home sweet home. You can get out of here, though. Yes, fun fact. Enemies can still shoot you while you have them trapped in gravity grenade, but you can just run right under them and suddenly they just can't do anything to stop it. Ooh, no, that's a beam bomb. No, that's a beam bomb. Get away from that. Ouch. Okay. So then, door finding device. Oh, hey there, Rux. How's it going? Well, I can talk to him out here? Okay. That's seems like an odd situation, but alright. Let's grab this. Hey there, secret door finder. Oh. Well, that was a hoot and a half to grab, wasn't it? Fun times. But that does thankfully conclude our mission. Sadly, we may have to interact with Janira again, but, you know. Just... Well, in any case, I hope you all have a good day, and I would quite like it if you subscribed for my troubles. Maybe one subscribe for each time I got teleported to the complete wrong location. And I'll see you next time. Good day.